Blog Talk Radio.
Welcome to the show. This is our first in the series for Living Well in 2012. And this show will be about super supplements and supplements that I have personally found really help me in my health and make me in an overall feel a whole lot better. I do have a disclaimer. Please note that I am not a doctor, nor do I claim to be. Any information I share is based on my own experiences, knowledge from research, or guidance I have received from professionals in the health field, including natural doctors. Anyone else who calls into the show with tips is also not a medical professional, unless otherwise stated as such. Therefore, it is advised not to take anything we say on my show as medical gospel. So just please keep in mind, this is just me sharing my opinion, things that have helped me, that have helped my family and friends, and the things that I have heard personally from actual doctors in the field, whether it be Western medicine or natural doctors. So I want to welcome everyone to the show. How is everybody doing? Robin, I got you on the line. How are you today, Robin?
Hey, doing well. Hello, everybody. Yeah, definitely want to have a little consultation with a health practitioner before taking any herb or supplements. It's always recommended in order to avoid any adverse side effects or drug interactions, guys, so you want to do that. So, yeah, I'm doing well. How are you today?
I'm doing pretty good myself. Just trying to keep up with my resolutions and all that kind of thing from the other show. And one of them is to try to be healthier, so I might as well spread the word what helps me, and hopefully I can help others with that. I noticed we also have someone else on hold. I'm pretty sure I know who this is, so I'm going to go ahead and get them in.
Okay, great.
Hello, welcome to the show. Who am I speaking to? Is this Denise?
Yes, it is. Hello, Lisa. Hello, Robin.
Hey,
hello, Denise.
Welcome back.
Yeah, thanks. I'm excited about tonight's show. This is definitely what I need to learn about, getting fit and getting in the right direction. So, and I got my pen and paper ready to take notes.
Yeah,
you
don't...
and me both. I'm not a supplement taker really either, so this is a learning thing for me as well. So, but I do have some things that I did some research that I'll share with you guys a little bit later.
Very cool. And keep in mind, anybody listening, if you aren't able to write it down quick enough, you can always go back and listen to the archive, and you can pause things, rewind, whatever you got to do to go ahead and write down the different things that you think might help you out. So, all right, well, I guess I'll go ahead and get started. I wanted to basically narrow it down to the top 10 I personally feel are the most important supplements that I think most everyone can get a huge benefit out of. And I wanted to start off with what I feel to be the most important vitamin that everyone absolutely should take. That's vitamin D3. As far as how much you should take a day, that can fluctuate anywhere from 400 IUs to 2,000, and it can go a whole lot higher if you're deficient in vitamin D. What is vitamin D deficiency? Well, it's a condition where the blood serum levels of vitamin D storage form, and the what's called the 25-OHD or calcidiol probably saying that wrong, are lower than which that which the body needs to properly maintain health. A deficiency in vitamin D should not be allowed to remain uncorrected for too long, even in those who are healthy. The longer the deficiency is allowed to persist, the greater the risk of serious health complications such as chronic illnesses, debilitation, or even early mortality. There are only two ways to correct a vitamin D deficiency. That's direct sunlight exposure, which of course is preferred. You should always get natural sunlight, which helps your body to produce the proper vitamin D itself. Or there's of course the supplementation, which I'm going to talk about a little bit more today. What causes a deficiency? Well, it's generally from lack of proper sun. If you don't get out in the sun enough, well, your skin's not going to get what it needs in order to start making that vitamin D naturally. And personally, in my opinion, and what I've researched, there's just too much out there telling people, stay out of the sun, it's going to give you cancer, put a big hat on, put a whole bunch of, you know, all of this sun protectant on, you know, you want to make sure to keep the sun away. And that's actually very wrong. And the deficiency of vitamin D is just all over the world right now. It's very high. And that's because people are mainly just hiding from the sun and putting all this sunblock on. And the problem with sunblock is people don't realize it, but it has a lot of toxins in it. And these toxins are, you've guessed it, they cause cancer, which is exactly the reason why people are using them to avoid the sun. So it's really a catch-22. And, the sun was put out there for a reason, whether, you want to believe that God put it out there as a gift to all of us, as many gifts are out there in nature, or if it's just part of nature. So I highly recommend that you get out there for at least half an hour a day of direct sunlight. Make sure that you're getting sun on your chest, your arms, your face, for at least 20 to 30 minutes a day. You'll get about 20,000 IUs naturally from your body's production, and it's just a wonderful thing. Another thing that you can do is to go tanning. I know a lot of people say, oh, that's cancer-causing too. Well, there's been studies on that too. It's not quite as dangerous as people think it is. Of course, those who walk around looking really, really, really tan and basically overdoing it, they are upping their risks, And the same thing with being in natural sunlight. But that's another way that you can get your natural sunlight almost the same, where it makes your body produce it, and that's to go to a tanning bed. Even if you go once a week, it helps up your levels of the vitamin D in your body. Did you have something to say, Robin?
No, I was just, I was just saying a lot of times, I think nowadays we do spend a lot more time indoors depending on who you are. I know the people, we're either online or we're doing something. So it is nice to get out and, we tend to forget that just a nice walk outdoors is sometimes what we need.
Well, exactly. A lot of people say, oh, get out and get fresh air. Oh, get a little sun. Well, it's so much more than just the lifting of your spirit, and there's another reason why vitamin D is so important, among many others, is it does lift your spirit. It's not just, oh, it's psychological. No, it's not. It's not just that. It's because when your vitamin D levels are raised up, it actually gives you a euphoric feeling, and that's because it's giving you the healthy dose that you need, which actually lifts your spirits. That's why you get the humdrums over the winter. A lot of people have these mood problems once it gets really, really cold out and you're stuck in the house all day and there's a lot of overcast. That's why a lot of people have the seasonal problems. It's not because it's dark and dreary. Well, it's because of the direct problem with not getting enough vitamin D. So people don't realize that. They think it's psychological. People go and get medications before it. All they really need to do is get themselves some vitamin D.
Can I make one comment about the vitamin D, just for those people that may be listening? I'm a healthcare aide, and I know that there are certain medications that people take where sunlight is, they have a photosensitivity.
Mm-hmm.
Correct,
yeah. Those people do have to be very careful. If anybody's taking a medication that does not work well with the sun, then that's where the vitamin D supplements are very necessary.
Right, and the tanning beds also would be a problem. So that's a good point to put up, Denise. Thanks for bringing that up. Also, there are risk factors for vitamin D. Those who have a darker complexion, they are at greatest risk for getting a deficiency to vitamin D. That's because they have much higher melanin content in their skin, and that basically kind of almost blocks the vitamin D levels from rising because the sun doesn't get in as well. Insufficient UVB exposure, working and playing indoors, covering up with clothes or sunscreen when outside, residing at a high latitude. Aging. Seniors are at greater risk due to lack of mobility and skin that is less responsive to UVB. Basically what UVB is that's the ultraviolet B, and that's the light from the sun that you need in order to get the vitamin D production going. I already mentioned that the darker skin, high incidence of vitamin D deficiency, and it's associated with conditions. It's widely documented. Breastfeeding. Breastfeeding will result in vitamin D deficiency in the baby if the mother fails to ensure her own levels are high enough to provide for her baby's needs as well. When a mother is deficient, the breastfed child will be deficient due to the low vitamin D content in the breast milk. And then another one that's big, and the final one, is obesity. Fat-soluble vitamin D gets trapped in the adipose tissue, which is the fat tissue, preventing its metabolization and utilization by the body. So in some ways, you almost have to take more, if you're overweight, of the supplement or get in the sun a little bit more often, because the body has a harder time getting that vitamin D to actually work because it does get trapped in the tissues. There are symptoms of vitamin D deficiency, things like chronic pain, weak bones, frequent infections, in other words, getting the flu a lot, not being able to fight things off, you know, the person that you work with that's always sick, always blowing their nose, constantly complaining that they don't feel well, they probably are deficient. Depression, as I mentioned before, if you don't get enough sunlight, you don't get the vitamin D, and your moods can drop very low. But the same will not be true for everyone who is deficient, though. Not everybody shows these types of signs right away. Sometimes it takes time. Other times people just trek along through life and they just don't know why they don't feel well. Because the possible effects of vitamin D deficiency are wide-ranging and can manifest in the body in any number of ways. There are no specific associated symptoms, but those are just a good list there that I personally have had a lot of these, except for the weak bones, but I was actually diagnosed with very low vitamin D levels. There are different amounts of vitamin D levels that tell you where your health is with the vitamin D levels. For me, 30 and below is very deficient. You definitely need to get out in the sun, or you definitely need to take some supplementation if you can't get out in the sun. Like Denise said, if you're on a medication that makes you photosensitive, obviously you don't want to go and do something that's going to break you out in a rash or possibly cause you other problems. But if you're 30 and below, my reading was far below 30. So I was in a world of hurt with pain, and, you know, I wasn't necessarily depressed, but I definitely felt blah, and I was just aching all over. It just felt horrible. I was so weak. I could barely move around, and I didn't know what was happening. I fortunately had a good doctor who tested me on that and found out where my problem was. Thank God it was something as simple as vitamin D deficiency. And then the next level up, you know, is like a good range, and that would be from like 30 to 60. That means you're in a healthy range. You're doing well. 60 to 100 is optimal if you're trying to fight off cancer. I don't want to make any, you know, particular statements here. I know that the FDA is real funny about this kind of stuff. So let's just say from my research and what I've learned, in that level, if you're trying to keep yourself at a low risk for cancer and possibly to get your body to naturally heal itself of cancer and some different ailments that deficiency will cause, from 60 to 100 is the range that you want to try to stay in if you're trying to get yourself healthier. And then anything over 100 is considered a little bit too much. I don't know too much about, you know, where that puts you as far as if it causes you issues if you have too much vitamin D. But there are some problems that can be associated with too much vitamin D. So it's important that you get your blood tested before you decide to supplement. You know, like I said in my disclaimer, I don't pretend to be a doctor. I'm only telling you what I've learned, what's helped me, you know, what my friends have done, my family's done, I've helped them as well, and it's really helped a lot of us out, and I just wanted to spread the word to help others as well and try to be healthier this year. But, yeah, so you're going to want to go to the doctor and get this blood test. And the blood test that you need to ask for is either called 25-hydroxyvitamin D or 25, and in parentheses, OHD test. And you can just simply say it's the vitamin D test to find out for deficiency. And most doctors are going to know exactly what you mean. I'm sorry, what was that?
Is there an overall test that they can test you for? Yeah, if you're a new person, new to this, and you're wanting to start using some type of supplementation rather than, you know, just the change of your diet, and so I'm going to make an appointment to the doctor, what do I ask him for? Do I have to ask him for each individual deficiency test to find out what I'm deficient? Or how would somebody go about starting this process of using supplements?
Well, yeah, that's a good idea to go and just get an overall panel done. They'll know what to do, especially if you go to somebody who's homeopathic and is more of a natural doctor, or if you go to a DO that is a Western medicine-type doctor that will also work with supplements. Your basic Western medicine doctor is not going to do these kinds of tests unless you insist, and even then they might not. So, you got to do your research. If you have a doctor that will not cooperate, you might want to look elsewhere to have somebody else help you out with it. But there is a panel. I don't know the exact term for it, but there is a particular panel that's an overall test that they do with your blood, and they basically test for the basic deficiency that most people have a problem with. And obviously, if the doctor sees certain symptoms coming from you and they think that you might need something done on top of that, then they'll go ahead and have you get the blood drawn for that as well. But as far as the vitamin D itself, you know, the hydroxy D vitamin D test is the one that you need to ask for when you go to the doctor. There's also the possibility that you don't have insurance and you can't really afford to go to a doctor. You can also purchase an in-home test kit that you can send to the lab yourself, and you don't need a requisition for it. You can do it yourself. It's very simple. There's quite a few out there that you can check into. I can tell you there is one in particular. Let me find the tab. It's a ZRT. That's the brand, ZRT. And you can look that up on their website, the ZRT Laboratory. And it's the in-home vitamin D testing kit. That's something that you can check into. Very simple. You just prick your finger and squeeze the blood into these little circular areas, and you have to send it in. The directions are all contained within it. You send it back into them with the amount of money that, you know, you're supposed to pay or whatever. That you should actually have already paid when you got the item, but if there was anything else that you were having them do on top of that, then you would send the additional funds. But 9 times out of 10, if you're just doing the vitamin D, you just go ahead and pay outright. They'll mail it to you. You do the little test, mail it back to them probably like immediately so that it's fresh. And then within 5 to 7 days, their website says they'll get those results back to you. So you'll know where you're at with your vitamin D. And like I said, again, if you don't have insurance or you don't have a doctor that's cooperative with this type of test, then you can do it that way. And they do offer a break on price if you wanted to get multiples as opposed to just getting one. Their website has it for $65. For $220, you can get four. And that comes in handy if you're upping your dosage and you want to test yourself in maybe 3 months to see if your levels are starting to rise back up to normal. So that's the way that you can get it done as far as the vitamin D, because that's the supplement I'm talking about right now. But as what Robin asked about, there is definitely a blood panel that they can do, which will do an overall test for very basic things that most people have a tendency to become deficient in. I do see we have some callers who have been very patiently waiting. Let me go ahead and get them on the line. I apologize for the wait. What's nice, though, is that the show definitely plays while you're on the phone. Keep that in mind, anyone who wants to call in, that you don't miss the show if you're on hold. It plays for the whole time on the phone. So let me go ahead and get you guys on here. Hello, welcome to the show. I'm guessing this is Matt. Is this Matt?
Hello, my ladies. How are you?
We are good.
Hello. Hello, Matt.
How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing fabulous. I'm actually enjoying this. You know, I didn't really know a lot about that. You know, I actually have seen myself maybe possibly even have some of those symptoms, you know what I mean, with the whole vitamin D, you know, just especially during wintertime, just being all grouchy, just, you know, kind of seeing a little down in the dumps. So I'm sitting here, I'm like, wow, I got to give me some vitamin D and give me some sunny delight.
Yes, you need some sunny D light as an outside.
In the Northwest, it's hard for us to find a sunny. We got to plan our sun breaks, I guess. You know, in between the rain. Oh, it's sunny.
Put a tanning bed, right, Robin?
Mm-hmm. Oh,
sorry.
I don't know about that. Really,
if you don't want to do that, then there's the supplements. But yeah, welcome to the show, Matt. Glad to have you on board. I'm glad it's something that you're interested in, and I definitely have more information too as we go. And if you have any questions in between here, feel free to ask. I'll do the best I can. Again, I have to keep repeating this. I'm not a professional, but I have researched this for years, and I've found a lot of things that I've been using supplement-wise have been helping me greatly in my family that I've told this to and friends and that. They've been using these things, and they've really helped them a lot. But let's go ahead and get the next caller on. I believe this to be Cherie, so let's get her on. Is this Cherie? Welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hello. How are
Hi,
you?
Hi, Cherie. Hey, Denise. Hey, Robin. Hey, Matt. Hey, Lisa. Oh, Shadow Lady.
Hi there.
So how are you doing this evening?
I'm doing fine, and I had come to the conclusion that I need some vitamin D as well. Actually, Danny Francis was telling me about it. And her husband has made such wonderful progress since he's been taking, you know, vitamin D supplements and everything. And I keep saying I'm going to do it. You would think I work in a pharmacy that I would have by now, but I haven't. But I'm bad about taking pills, and I really, really, really think it would help me tremendously if I did. So I'm so glad you're talking about it.
That's
true. That's really good.
With her working in a, with you working in a pharmacy, Cherie, Art, what are you normally seeing going out over the counter the most, as far as supplements?
I actually work for we are a long-term care facility, we nursing home, and
oh, I
so we have some facilities that we provide for. And it's been a while since I've been in retail, but we do a lot of vitamin D. For our patients and stuff. So apparently it does do. I mean, I've always known that vitamin D helps, like if you take calcium, that if you take it with the D, it helps absorb the nutrients, you know, better and all. But I didn't realize just how important vitamin D really is. But,
yes, it really is. And like I mentioned earlier, it's unbelievable how many people are deficient. But when you think about the fact that it's out there, you know, everybody's being taught, well, cover up, it's not good to be in the sun, and make sure to put this sun protectant on. You got to have the sunscreen that's like 1,000, you know, on the rating scale. You know, normally, you know, you're like, whoa. When you were growing up, you were only using, if you used any, you were only using maybe 15, right? And now it's like, oh, you have to use, like, you know, I don't even know the highest. I'm just guessing 100, but it's crazy what the protectant is on that. And that's another thing. You really only need about 15. I think after 30, it just doesn't do any different. You're just putting on more chemicals on your body. The higher they go up in that coverage, it's just, it's sad. It really is that people just trust the commercials. They just think, oh, well, I saw it on the commercials, so I got to go ahead and get some of that. But maybe if the word gets out a bit more about people taking the vitamin D and getting out in the sun, not being so afraid to be in it, especially if they don't have medications that make them sensitive to it, there's no reason why you shouldn't. So.
But I've always known that, you know, it's good to get out in the sun some, but, you know, not too much, and that you need some vitamin D and all. But I didn't realize just how much it affects you when you have a deficiency of vitamin D. I had no clue. And something I probably should have known and everything. And then when she was telling me about her husband, all I was like, that really sounds like something I need to do, because I'm always, I just feel down all the time. And, you know, I try to be, you know, I just don't feel good. Like tonight, I didn't think I was going to be up for the show and everything, because I just have felt bad all day. But, you know, I really need to, you know, I really need to check into it and try it. I'm sure it will probably do a lot of work for me.
Yeah, I really think it will, especially if you get the test. You'll know exactly where your reading is at. And if once you know your level is low, you definitely want to start doing that. I could probably talk to you privately and help you out with that as far as, you know, what you, how much you should take according to what I've researched and that. Of course, if you go to the doctor's going to tell you anyway. But I just noticed I'm hearing, like, sound. I don't know if someone's got their volume up on their speaker, or maybe they've got a TV playing in the background. So if anybody has that, they could just turn that down. I was hearing kind of like a repeat of the show, kind of like the delay, you know. Does anybody have
it? Yeah, if you're on the phone, just go ahead and turn down your speaker a little bit.
Yeah.
Anybody on the computer and on the other page had the show on, so it was the one that was coming through, so I apologize.
Oh, no problem. People don't realize that you can actually hear that when you're on the phone, but, yeah, it will pick up that delay, and it'll keep playing in the background. It sounds like you've got a party going on over there. But on to the next thing about vitamin D. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I always heard, too, that you have to watch out on supplements as well, as to make sure that there's so many, like, synthetic-type supplements that you have to know really.
Absolutely, yeah.
You know, you need to go to, like, maybe the health food store and pay a little extra just to make sure that you're getting the right, and you don't have all, you know, the extra chemicals or whatever that some come with and everything. You getting the actual, you know, I really don't know how to explain it. It's just, you know, there's a lot of synthetic products out there.
Right. It's man-made, and it's not natural that they're using. It's not going to help you. You're just going to flush it out when you go to the bathroom, and that's going to be about it. But, yeah, I did say vitamin D3, I believe, but it has to be vitamin D3 to really assimilate into your body properly. Vitamin D2 will do it somewhat, but vitamin D3 is the best, because your body can really break it down a lot better and use it. So I highly recommend vitamin D. For me personally, and this is just what I've been using, and it's wonderful, and I've got a lot of other people using it, I use Vitacost brand, and it used to be called Nutraceutical Sciences Institute. But now, instead of NSI, they just call it the Vitacost brand, which is basically theirs. So if you go to Vitacost.com, their prices are very affordable. Many times they have coupons, and they have a lot of coupons going on their own brand, and they are very particular about what they use in them, and they make sure that it's definitely natural. They don't put a bunch of man-made chemicals in there that really aren't going to help you. Because it's like what you said there, Cherie, if you get a bunch of the supplements that are just man-made and they're a bunch of chemicals, and they're just, you know, basically a waste of your money, because it's not going to help you, and if anything, it, you know, could build up and cause you problems in your system, or you're just going to flush it out when you go to the bathroom. So, yeah, that's actually a really good point to make. Absolutely. But I do have 7 health benefits of vitamin D. You will find it's unbelievable how much vitamin D can do for you, not just the things I mentioned before, but I'm going to go ahead and read this. Vitamin D is a fat-soluble nutrient found in animal foods such as eggs, milk, cod, shrimp, salmon, and sardines. It is known for preventing the bone disease rickets. Below are 7 additional and no less important health reasons to include vitamin D in your diet. Well, one real obvious one is bone health. The minerals calcium and phosphorus form a large part of the substance hydroxyapatite, which makes up over half of our bone composition. 2 substances, however, primarily regulate the body's use of calcium and phosphorus: parathyroid hormone, PTH, and vitamin D. The parathyroid hormone triggers the release of calcium from our bones into our bloodstream when levels drop too low. Vitamin D, on the other hand, prevents the parathyroid hormone from drawing too much upon our bone supply of calcium by helping our intestines absorb more calcium and allowing our kidneys to hold on to more calcium. By regulating our PHT function, or the parathyroid hormone, vitamin D not only protects our bone health, but also fights against too much calcium in our bloodstream that can cause cardiovascular problems. The second one is immunity. Vitamin D plays a crucial role in our immune system by triggering macrophage cells that release antibacterial proteins. These proteins are shown to prevent infections, including Mycobacterium tuberculosis, responsible for tuberculosis, and Mycobacterium leprae, if I mispronounce things, I apologize, responsible for leprosy. Another big one is blood pressure. I found since I've been taking vitamin D that my blood pressure is a lot better. And I can mention that as far as the other, I don't know about my bones, but because you'd have to get a scan to find out about that. But as far as immunity, I almost never get sick anymore. I mean, if I get sick, it's mainly because I have stomach issues or whatever, because I do have stomach problems. But as far as, like, getting head colds or flus, my family and I that are taking the vitamin D, we do not get sick. Other people are hacking up a lung and feeling horrible, and, you know, we may have other things that we have going on with our health. But as far as getting the flu or needing any shots or any of that kind of thing, we don't need any of that. But back to the blood pressure. Vitamin D helps to manage our blood pressure by monitoring the system that increases our blood pressure when it gets too low, called the renin-angiotensin system. Our blood needs a healthy dose of vitamin D to inhibit this system from raising our blood pressure too high. Another is insulin. It actually helps you for people who, you know, get diabetes or have diabetes. As mentioned above, vitamin D regulates the levels of the parathyroid hormone from releasing too much calcium into the bloodstream. An overdose of parathyroid hormone in our bloodstream can cause fat cells to collect too much calcium, triggering the cells to produce too much cortisol, which I don't know if anybody out there knows what cortisol is, but it makes you heavy.
Oh, yeah.
It's very bad for you. It also hyperspazzes your body up, and you get into that whole fight-or-flight mode with it, too. It's a hormone that counteracts the effect of insulin, making it difficult for the body to metabolize sugars. Furthermore, when too much calcium collects, our cells stop producing the GLUT-4, a protein that helps transfer sugar into the bloodstream and to our cells. GLUT-4, however, functions only when triggered by insulin. Without sufficient vitamin D, not only do our bodies produce too little GLUT-4 to transport the necessary sugars to our cells, but also lacks the effectiveness of insulin to stimulate that process. Another one, as mentioned in having problems with your muscles, studies have shown that a vitamin D deficiency not only leads to decreased muscle strength, independent of muscle mass, but also may inhibit proper nerve firing and triggering of muscle contractions. So you're going to have all this muscle tension, you're going to have nerve issues in your muscles, just crazy stuff with that. And then a big one is cancer. Vitamin D has been shown to prevent certain types of cancer, including bladder, breast, colon, ovarian, prostate, melanoma, and rectal cancer. So that's a big one there, too. And the last one on the list is mental health. Recommended intake of vitamin D regularly greatly reduces the risk of age-related cognitive disorders such as senile dementia, Alzheimer's disease, and mood disorders such as depression. So as I mentioned before, as far as depression goes, it definitely helps lift your spirits because it is actually changing the chemistry of your body to be able to have a better mood and to be able to feel better inside. So those are the 7 for vitamin D there. Does anybody have anything to add?
I'm going right now to get some.
She's in the car driving.
No.
Now, if anybody makes a joke about the Arby's parking lot from the previous show, this is not the day. Right?
Yeah.
We don't have Arby's. I haven't had Arby's
right now.
Chance.
But you can see why I put it as my number one. Now, the next other 9 that I have listed that I've chosen, they're not in any particular order, really, but I did put vitamin D3 as numero uno for obvious reasons.
Now, is that something you take?
I'm sorry, Robin. What was that?
Is that something that you – so you take that every day, correct?
Oh, absolutely, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely, every single day. And my doctor that I go to, that's a natural doctor, she actually told me when I brought all my supplements and had her look over them and tell me what was good and what wasn't, she basically took everything, told me what, you know, how it was, what it was, you know, going to do for me and if it was good. And then she shoved them all aside. She picked up the vitamin D bottle, put it in my hand and said, if you want to be well, she said, if you take one supplement only, this is the one. So this is an actual professional doctor. She's Western medicine, and she also does a lot of natural doctoring. So,
well, I know the use of complementary and alternative medicine in the United States, it just continues to expand. I mean, it's a huge industry. So, you know, there's a lot of people out there that maybe, like me, a little bit leery of just, you know, grabbing something off of the shelf and putting it into your body. But, again, for you that might have just started to tune in, we do ask that you do consult with a health practitioner before taking any herbs or supplements as recommended in order to avoid any adverse side effects or drug interactions that you may have. So if you take any supplements and you want to share with us, please call into the show. You can call at 424-243-9676. So?
Okay, thanks a lot for sharing that, Robin. It's true. There really has been a large raising of awareness about our bodies and natural ways of doing things, because I'm not going to get in a whole blown-up discussion on this. I still have 9 other supplements to talk about, but you know, I'm not going to go into, like I said, there may be another, we may do another series of shows having to do with living well. But as far as medicines that people take that are prescribed by the doctor that aren't natural, that are man-made, I have some very strong opinions and feelings about those. And I know some people feel that they need them, and if they don't have them, that they wouldn't survive, and their bodies need them to, you know, to either stay healthy or, you know, to not have a problem where they end up dying from it, obviously, if it's bad enough. But unfortunately, because of this, a lot of people are having a lot of bad side effects. And I'm not saying natural medicine or natural supplements can't sometimes have side effects as well, because pretty much anything can. But a lot of the prescribed medications have really, really dangerous side effects. And some of them, you know, whether they interfere with the other medications you may be taking, they also can give you other ailments. Blood pressure pills have given people diabetes, cholesterol problems. Sometimes they give you false readings when you're getting your blood drawn. And, oh, you have diabetes, now we have to give you more medication. Oh, you have high cholesterol, now you need more of this medication. And the next thing you know, someone's popping 10 pills a day and they feel horrible from all the side effects. So I highly recommend. I'm sorry?
I said exactly. You'll be on a medication, you're having side effects from that medication, so they give you something else to counteract that side effect. And then it's just like a vicious cycle. And then, you know, like you said, you're taking about 10 pills a day because you're trying to offset all the different side effects that are affecting you, but you supposedly need this medication.
Yes, exactly. From the original pill that they actually gave you. So, yeah, I'm not a big fan of that.
Yeah,
I'm
sorry. Go ahead, Denise.
Okay. In regards to what you're saying with the vitamin D can cause depression, okay, therefore, as you know, that there's an epidemic of depression, and depression medications are, in high demand, you know, high supply, okay? Certain depression medications, the higher you go, the stronger, you know, the higher dosage, the stronger depression medication you take, can cause tardive dyskinesia, which is it's a very bad effect on your body. It will prevent you from sitting still, you're constantly moving. It causes, the
ticks in the mouth and the tongue and that,
mm-hmm.
yes. And they can be permanent. They can be permanent. They don't just go away when you get off the medication for everyone.
Right.
Some people get stuck with them the rest of their lives, and that is really scary.
Exactly.
So you have to be really careful what you take. And, my personal recommendation, again, not a doctor, but from what I've learned and what I know, I would much rather try something natural before I jump in and take something that's synthetic, because you have no idea what terrible things could happen to you. It's very rare that the natural things do horrible things to people, because they're God-made. They're put out there for a reason. They're on our planet. They're out there aplenty. And they were put here because they were meant for us to use. So, and I'm not trying to downshoot the other things. I know there are some times where certain medications, for example, for someone who has schizophrenia, that is a very difficult thing to treat. And I haven't done a whole lot of research on it, but I do know people who have it. And unfortunately, that's a really bad situation where they kind of have to be on really strong psychotropic drugs. And the antipsychotics they take do shorten their lifespan. And as Denise mentioned, I can't even pronounce that right now. I know the word, but I have to.
Tardive dyskinesia.
Yes, people end up getting that, and it's horrible, but it's either that or they can't function, and it's sad, but there are certain things that you almost have to have medication for, but for the most part, there are so many other natural options for you to try. I'm going to go ahead and start talking about number two, which is magnesium. Magnesium is another big, huge one. I personally don't think I would be functioning as well as I am today without it, because I have a lot of hormone problems, and magnesium really, really gets eaten up if you have a high estrogen level, which I do. As far as daily doses, it can range anywhere from 250 milligrams up to a safe dose of 1,000. Now, while that might sound like a lot, and like I mentioned, the higher doses on the vitamin D3, people don't realize that the doses that are approved and put in your supplements and such that are just like, say, your multivitamins, your typical multivitamins, they are actually way lower than what your body really needs. So you can safely take up to 1,000 magnesium, and the benefits are enormous. Here's the top five health benefits of magnesium. Magnesium is an essential mineral for staying healthy and is required for more than 300 biochemical reactions in the body. Multiple health benefits of magnesium include transmission of nerve impulses, body temperature regulation, detoxification, energy production, and the formation of healthy bones and teeth. Health specialists have always emphasized the importance of including an adequate amount of vitamins and minerals in our daily diet. Zinc, calcium, and magnesium are three of which are the most important minerals essential for good health. Magnesium aids in the absorption of calcium by the body, while zinc actively supports the body's immune system. Women of all ages benefit immensely from the intake of magnesium. Besides keeping osteoporosis at bay, magnesium health benefits in women include relief from symptoms of menopause and premenstrual syndrome. That would be me. It also minimizes the risk of premature labor. The other crucial health benefits of magnesium include protein synthesis, relief from bronchospasm, or constricted airways in the lungs, and improvement of parathyroid function. It boosts the bioavailability of vitamin B6 and cholesterol, improves muscle functioning, and prevents osteoporosis, insomnia, constipation, heart attacks, hypertension, migraines, kidney stones, and gallstones. Good dietary sources of magnesium include nuts, especially almonds, whole grains, wheat germ, fish, and green leafy vegetables. As with most nutrients, daily needs for magnesium cannot be met from food alone, which is why magnesium supplements are recommended as well. The top five health benefits of magnesium are, just one second, I need some water here. I think my tongue was sticking to the roof of my mouth. Okay. One, magnesium may reverse osteoporosis. Multiple research studies conducted have suggested that calcium supplemented with magnesium improves bone mineral density. Magnesium deficiency alters calcium metabolism and the hormones that regulate calcium, resulting in osteoporosis. Intake of recommended levels of magnesium is important because it averts osteoporosis. Two, magnesium prevents cardiovascular diseases. One of the most important benefits of magnesium is that it is associated with lowering the risk of coronary heart diseases. Dietary surveys have suggested that sufficient magnesium intake may reduce the chance of having a stroke. Magnesium deficiency increases the risk of abnormal heart rhythms or arrhythmias, which increase the risk of complications after a heart attack. Therefore, consuming recommended amounts of magnesium dietary supplements may be beneficial to the cardiovascular system. Three, magnesium regulates high blood pressure or hypertension. Magnesium plays a key role in regulating blood pressure naturally. Magnesium supplements and diet include plenty of fruits and vegetables, which are good sources of potassium and magnesium, are consistently associated with lowering high blood pressure. Four, magnesium treats diabetes. Studies show that individuals with magnesium deficiency have a risk of developing type 2 diabetes and severe diabetic retinopathy, which is hurting your eyes and getting glaucoma. Magnesium aids in carbohydrate metabolism and influences the release and activation of insulin, thereby controlling blood glucose levels. It has been proven that for every 100 milligrams of increased magnesium daily intake, there was a 15% decrease in the risk of developing type 2 diabetes. Five, magnesium treats migraines, insomnia, and depression. The numerous magnesium health benefits also include the treatment of migraines, insomnia, and symptoms of depression. Magnesium is also known to cure severe forms of psychiatric dysfunctions, including panic attacks, stress, anxiety, and undue agitations. Magnesium supplements considerably reduce the severity of such attacks and may also help in reducing the rate of recurrence. So there's some really big things that are helped by taking magnesium as well. I personally, as far as name brands, I take Nature's Way for magnesium, and I actually use a complex magnesium. And I highly recommend, in my research, and found that citrate is the best blend to use. There are several different magnesium types that you can take, and citrate is the, as I like the vitamin D3, it is the best assimilated into your body, and it definitely does a lot more than the other versions, as far, or I should say types, not really versions. But does anybody have any questions or anything to add to that?
Testing 1, 2, people.
I'm about ready to break it down.
We use a lot of Magog as well for, you know, for our patients too. So it's generally like 400 milligrams once or twice a day, usually just once a day. But I didn't know that about Mag, that it was that, you know, that important as well. Well, I'm going to have a list to start taking. I'm not good at taking stuff.
Oh, I know. I know. I didn't like taking a whole handful of stuff either, but when you see how much better it makes you feel and you don't get sick all the time, believe me, it's worth the bother.
Right. Right. I have a very forgetful mind. I keep saying I'll get ginkgo, but I keep forgetting to take it.
Yeah, that's the highest I was actually doing research on that, and that's the highest or the top seller in the United States. They did $288 million selling ginkgo biloba, is it, last year. So it was interesting. So a lot of people taking that.
Yeah, absolutely, because a lot of people are having problems with their memory. And there's a lot of reasons for that, but I can't get to all of that in one show. But there are a lot of reasons why people are becoming more forgetful, and some of it is lack of vitamin D. It obviously helps brain function. There's some other things on my list here that help that as well. The third one I want to mention and is very closely tied into vitamin D as well as magnesium, especially magnesium, is calcium. That's number three on my list. That's something that you can take roughly 500 to 2,000 milligrams daily safely. Let me go ahead and talk about the benefits. Among all the benefits, calcium, the important ones are that it aids in maintaining bone health, dental health, prevention of colon cancer, reduces obesity, etc. We need calcium right from birth till old age. In infant days, calcium is required for proper bone and teeth growth. During adolescence, as the bones develop, calcium is again essential to supplement and support the development. While we get older, our bones tend to get porous and weak, thereby calling for ample calcium intake. With so many fancy diets around us, we often tend to avoid calcium-rich foods, whole food groups like dairy products, which result in calcium deficiency. Reports say that calcium deficiency conditions are continually rising. Particularly women who are on low-calorie diets to get slim often confront the trouble of osteoporosis. Thus, it is extremely important to consume enough calcium, along with vitamins D, magnesium, I'm stumbling over my words today, and K2. I don't know a whole lot about K2, along with your tender and adolescent years. Calcium forms 2% of the total body weight of an adult human. Calcium is found in the human body as deposits in the bones and teeth in great volumes. Traces of calcium are also present in the circulatory system, which prevents life-threatening hemorrhages. Calcium is easily available in milk and milk products like cheese and yogurt. Moreover, nuts, tinned salmon, seeds, and pulses are also good sources of calcium. It is a popular idea that milk is the greatest source of calcium, but it's not so. Broccoli can actually increase the calcium levels in your diet the best. It is noteworthy that semi-skimmed or whole milk have an almost similar calcium content. Fishes like salmon and sardines, leafy green vegetables including broccoli, spinach, orange juice, cereals, oysters, rice beverages, soy, almonds, black-eyed peas, green peas, and ricotta are also rich sources of calcium. There are symptoms of calcium deficiency, obviously, and what they are is realizing calcium deficiency in the body is quite easy. It's when your muscles ache and twitch, or you get sudden cramps and spasms, palpitations, high blood pressure, osteoporosis, loose teeth, and gum diseases. Insomnia, premenstrual cramps, hypertension, and arthritis also indicate calcium deficiency. Often, many children suffer from rickets. The bones become weak and flexible. They have bowed legs, sunken chests, and beaded ribs. They have not been nourished with calcium from birth itself. Thus, regular calcium supply is very important in growing children and teenagers, as it can substantially reduce the risk of osteoporosis in old age. This bone ailment is common in one out of every three women and in one man in every 12 above 50 years of age. The benefits of calcium are very good. Calcium is essential in helping you to have healthy bones, gums, and teeth. Doctors often recommend women to take calcium supplements who show early signs of bone problems such as osteoporosis or osteopenia. It strengthens your bones. Calcium strengthens your backbone and ensures the right shape to the body apart from alleviating the risks of back pain. Calcium helps to keep the bones in good shape and prevents many skeletal complaints such as arthritis and osteoporosis, which can hamper the free movement apart from being extremely painful. It prevents obesity. Calcium efficiently helps in maintaining an optimum body weight in both males and females. If there is any deficiency in calcium in your diet, the body shall tend to release parathyroid hormone. Again, that's bringing that parathyroid up, which in turn stimulates the bones to release calcium in your bloodstream, therefore keeping the balance. On the other side, parathyroid hormones also stimulate the production of fat and preventing its breakdown, which can, again, make you obese. So to ensure that you're taking the right amount of calcium is very important so that the obesity problem doesn't creep up in with other related health hazards. It also protects cardiac muscles. Calcium protects your heart muscles when you use sufficient amounts. It helps the muscles to do the contraction and relax properly. Calcium also helps the nervous system to maintain the proper pressure in your arteries. If there's a calcium drop, a hormone called calcitrol is released, which contracts the smooth muscles of the arteries, thereby increasing blood pressure. Cardiac muscles need extracellular calcium ions for contraction. When the intercellular contraction or concentration of calcium, when the intercellular concentration of calcium increases, the calcium ions gather together to the protein troponin that stimulates, troponin that stimulates extracellular fluid and the intracellular stores, even the skeletal muscle, which is only activated by calcium stored in the sarcoplasmic reticulum. It also prevents colon cancer. Adequate calcium assures you to alleviate the overall risk of colon cancer and suppresses the growth of polyps that can lead to cancer. Calcium supplementation reduces the risk of oedemas, I cannot pronounce things today, also non-malignant tumors in the colon. This is actually a precursor to colon cancer.
Right.
It's still not known if calcium intake minimalizes the cancer risk completely. The excess calcium that's left in your intestines after your body absorbs what it needs. On its way through the colon, this unabsorbed calcium is believed to bind with cancer promoters. So they're excreted together from the body. Studies have shown that both food sources of calcium and calcium supplements provide this protective effect. Calcium supplements should be taken in liquid form because liquid vitamins absorb 5 times better than the pill. So what this is saying is it's really best to take it in liquid form if you can. But it doesn't mean that the regular capsules and such can't work. But if you can get a calcium supplement that's in liquid form or possibly in the liquid gel type, that would definitely break down much faster. It also prevents premenstrual blues. Adequate amounts of calcium lessens the symptoms of premenstrual syndrome like dizziness, mood swings, hypertension, and so on. Low levels of calcium might trigger the release of hormones, which are responsible for premenstrual mood swings, including irritability and depression, amongst many others. It also prevents kidney stones. Kidney stones are actually the crystallized deposits of calcium and other minerals in the human urinary tract. The most common form of kidney stones is the oxalate stones. Previously, it was thought that high calcium intakes or high calcium absorption develops the kidney stones, but the latest studies show that high dietary calcium intake decreases the hazards of stones considerably. In short, dietary calcium does not cause kidney stones, but the excess calcium present in water that results in kidney stones. Other factors like high oxalate consumption from leafy vegetables like kale and spinach and reduced fluid consumption can prove to be a big cause for kidney stones. So basically, you might be taking a normal amount of calcium into your body, but if you're not drinking enough water and you're dehydrated, the calcium is going to start to form into stones, and that's basically the biggest reason why people end up with stones. And I have had a calcium stone that I passed that was in my kidney that came out, and it was very, very painful in addition to having gallstones. And it's I'm over here helping you guys out with different supplements you should use, but I'm guilty of not drinking enough water all the time. And that's another thing we're going to be talking about in a later show. But water is also extremely important in addition to supplements. Another thing that it does is it ensures a healthy alkaline pH level. Junk foods, excess sugars, and preserved food items contribute to forming acidity in the body, which in turn can give rise to various diseases such as cancer, kidney stones, and hypertension. Calcium helps to balance and allow your body to have a healthy pH level, thereby improving your vitality and overall health. Another one, we got so many good ones here, is controlling your blood pressure. It says that here that the vegetarian diet with a high amount of calcium, researchers have declared that magnesium and potassium and fiber will show you reduced blood pressure, while other researchers concluded that different opinions have said that increased calcium intake results in hypertension. Later it was seen that the reason for such assorted results was because these studies tested the effect of single nutrients rather than food sources having the nutrient content. Natural Institutes of Health conducted a research called Dietary Approaches to Stop Hypertension, or the DASH diet. I'm not sure if anybody's heard of that. It's pretty popular, and it really, really does work. The typical American diet was compared with two altered diets that were rich in fruits and vegetables and a combo DASH diet stuffed with fruits, vegetables, and calcium. The results showed increased calcium intake decreases high blood pressure issues.
I do have a question.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
We all know that the right supplements can help your heart, sharpen your immune system. Well, they can even improve your sex life, okay? The wrong ones, however, can be ineffective or even sometimes harmful. How much is that go along with when do we, if we're taking care of our diet, when do we know when we need a supplement? That's what I'm trying to determine. Because, I mean, if you're eating healthy, are you not getting these magnesium, calcium, you know, in a proper diet? When is it that people decide that they're not getting enough in their diet that they need to go to a supplement?
Well, that's where you run into where the next show we're going to have, we're going to talk about superfoods and having foods that actually have nutrients in them without having to supplement. And the reason why you run into a problem and end up having to supplement is when you're not eating organic foods that aren't laced with a bunch of horrible chemicals in pesticides and, you know, GMO, which is genetically modified things. So, unfortunately, most of the food that's out there does not have what it used to in it, which is what I'm mentioning here, these important nutrients. The vitamins and minerals are virtually mostly gone, and food is so overly processed. You know, anything that's in a can or anything that's been, you know, prepackaged and put in the freezer and little boxes of macaroni and cheese and things like that, those have very little nutritional value to them. And in addition, you're getting a lot of toxins and a lot of bad things chemically wise that you do not want in your system. And they will defeat the purpose of even eating the food for nutrition. So that's a slightly different topic. But, yeah, unfortunately,
in the American diet, that is true. You know, we tend to, like we were saying on another show, whether or not we have time or not, we tend to go out and grab a burger or we go here or there. There's a fast food restaurant on every corner, it seems. And so a lot of times maybe we're engaging or we're eating foods that aren't really that good for us. So you're saying that this supplementation really provides something that we're not getting in our normal everyday American diet, correct?
Right, and yes, you're right. It's mainly the American diet, and so it's kind of spreading around the world, unfortunately. They're pressuring the different countries to have GMO food, and a lot of them are very up in arms about it because they don't want the unhealthy food that we have here. If you look at people in different countries, you'll find they're healthy. They're walking around with lots of energy. You come over and start looking at a bunch of us over here in America, and you'll find a lot of overweight people that don't have a whole lot of kick in their stuff. And I'm not saying that's everyone, but if you do not eat organic, and unfortunately organic is very costly, or you don't grow your own vegetables and fruits, you are going to need to supplement if you want to make sure you're getting all your nutrition in. And the only real way to test that, obviously, is getting blood drawn and finding out from your doctor. And it's unfortunate that we have to go to this length to be able to be healthy. You know, in the good old days, we just ate our food and knew that it was going to be good for us. But unfortunately, that's not the case unless you have your own garden or, you know, you have a local farm that you can go to, that you can purchase the foods that you need. Or maybe you go to a store, you know, something that's like Trader Joe's or Whole Foods. We have a really great one over here called Earth Fair that I love. But unfortunately, not everyone can afford everything that they want to have that way.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Supplements
take
are...
Take advantage of your roadside vegetable stands, people.
You can't find them.
We have our apples in cold storage for 6 months before they get to us. So, you know, the food, the way that we process our food here in the United States is a lot different, like you said, from 20 years ago. We could get a lot of the vitamins and minerals that we could. Again, too, you know, we just need to put a little bit more attention in what we're putting into our bodies or the quality of food that we're getting. Unfortunately, it's hard, you know, when you're on a budget to do that. But, you know, it's like everything else now. You really have to pay attention, it seems, to do just the simplest of things.
And if I can take, if I could just make a statement that as a witness for Lisa, now this is not prompted anybody listening. I'm just going to say this on my own. Okay, Lisa, Robin, and I have been BFFs for 9 years. And prior to Lisa getting involved in all of this healthy supplements and natural doctors, natural medicine, she suffered a lot. And I, you know, always felt bad for her. She was always sick. She always had issues, like health issues. And now she just, right, Lisa? I mean, you don't really, you're not sick anymore. Lisa?
I'm here. I'm listening.
I mean, back me up now, you know, but I'm speaking from, like, what I've seen. You know, I know I was always there for you, always felt bad for how bad your body felt, and you were always ill, but you just don't feel that, you know. Is that right?
Yeah, well, it's nice to see that it's being noticed, but, yeah, you're right. I mean, before I was supplementing and before I cared about what I put in my mouth, I just was eating a bunch of junk and, you know, I didn't really take care of myself. And, you know, you were around in my life long enough to see the difference. So, you know, thanks for pointing that out. But, yeah, definitely. I mean, if there's an example right there, just me alone and somebody who's actually observed it. I mean, I was like, you know, going over to the drive-thru, picking up drive-thru food because it was so much faster. You know, putting in the 5-minute meals from Michelinas in the microwave and, you know, whatever was fastest, whatever was easy. And, you know, I had other people saying to me, oh, you should really stop doing that, or, you know, maybe you should take supplements, it might help you. And, oh, yeah, whatever. You know, I didn't want to hear it. To be honest with you, I was not as open-minded as I am today. But I have seen huge differences in me. Do I have health problems still? Yeah, I've got some hormone stuff, but I'm going through perimenopause. I'm going to have that. But there are things I can do to get through it a little bit easier. And I actually do have a perimenopause group on Facebook in addition to some other things I have going on, and I try my best to help people there too. But, yeah, Denise, thanks for pointing that out, and I'm glad to see you've noticed a difference.
Absolutely, and I'm just, you know, happy for you. I know that you're feeling a lot better now.
I certainly couldn't have a radio show like, say, maybe 5 years ago. Wouldn't have happened.
Right.
So thanks a lot for pointing that out.
You noticed that too, Robin. Robin, correct? You've been with us for 9 years, right, Robin? You feel the same way about Lisa?
Oh, yeah. I definitely see a big difference in her, and I'm glad to hear it. Yeah, absolutely see a difference. Absolutely.
Okay, well, I'm going to go ahead and just finish up what I had here to read. I hate doing all this reading, and I'm stumbling over my words because it's so boring to read, but unfortunately, I mean, I'm giving you my own knowledge, but I don't know absolutely everything, and I may not remember everything I want to cover. So I'm going to go ahead and finish for talking about calcium. And then what I'm going to do is just go down the line and just say very little about the other remaining ones, because otherwise we're going to run out of time, and we're not going to have a lot of time for questions and such. So I'll just go ahead and finish up what I have to say here for calcium, and then I'm going to go down and give you the other ones that I feel are very important. And keep in mind, this is just my own personal list. There are other things out there that are important food-wise. Some of the things that I eat are taking up for some of the supplements I'm not necessarily taking. So, but these are the ones that I personally recommend. Again, not a doctor. So back to where I was at, we were talking about the DASH diet. It says, to help test the combined effects of nutrients, including calcium from food on blood pressure, a study was conducted to investigate the impacts of various eating patterns on blood pressure. This study, titled, was reported by PHE, which I'm not sure what company that is, examined the effects of three different diets on high blood pressure. And overall, it appears that having enough calcium really made a huge difference. Also, there are two other things that it definitely helps. Maintaining healthy teeth and gums. Calcium protects your teeth by keeping the jawbone strong and sturdy all through your life, which in turn ensures tight-fitting teeth where bacteria cannot thrive. Thus, before your teeth and gums start giving trouble, ensure a calcium-rich diet regularly. Calcium intake should be highly considered, especially from a tender age, so that your kids will naturally grow up with strong teeth. helps in transportation of nutrients. Calcium helps in the easy movement of nutrients across cell membranes. Okay, so that pretty much covers that, but keep in mind, too, another thing that you need to know. When you're taking calcium and magnesium, the ratio that I was taught is that you're supposed to have twice the amount of calcium to what you take for magnesium. So, for example, say you're taking 500 milligrams daily of magnesium. What I was told and taught was that you need to take 1,000 milligrams of calcium because you have to have a certain ratio for it to work properly in your body. So this is another thing I wanted to make sure to point out. The other things on my list that I've put down, the fourth one I put down is fish oil. You can take roughly around 600 or 1,000 daily, very careful, a very good amount. I'm just going to go ahead and read off the list of the wonderful benefits without going into extreme detail because I see we're running tight on time here. It promotes cardiovascular health and protects against heart attack and stroke is one. Two, reduces inflammation and pain and promotes healthy joints. Three, supports mental focus and long-term cognitive function. Absolutely, omega-3s help your brain because it gives you that fatty acid content that your brain needs to function properly, and it can actually improve the things that you have going on, whether it's lack of memory or you can't think properly during the day or you have a fuzzy brain, people like to say. Well, if you take the fish oil, it's going to help you have a clearer thinking and you're going to be able to do the things that you need to do without getting confused and being forgetful and all that. It really does help. Let's see. Number four, supports positive mood and emotional well-being. I was taught by the doctor I go to that it's wonderful to take fish oil for depression. It's another thing that's important that will help if you have mood swings or depression. Anything that will give your body the sufficient amount of fatty acids in your brain will definitely help your brain function much better. Number five, it promotes eye health. Very important because you get dry eye syndrome if you don't have proper intake, and you will get macular degeneration, which obviously you start to lose your vision, which is extremely scary. Number six, pregnancy, infant brain eye development, and less incidence of childhood disorders. So it's very important to have a good amount of fish oil, whether it's from your food or supplementation while you're pregnant. Number seven, promotes optimal fat metabolism. Believe it or not, fatty acids actually help to break down the fat in your body because it's healthy fat, just like there's a lot of healthy oils out there. Things like coconut oil are very good for you, and it was told for years that it was horrible and you need to stay away from it. Saturated fats are not all bad. Number eight, lowers risk of prostate, breast, and colorectal. Colorectal. Okay, this is going to be probably a joke on me. I can never pronounce anything. Okay, so those are all eight really important things that it does. I have to make an important point that, unfortunately, when you take fish oil, a lot of people complain of a fishy taste in their mouth or they get fish burps, which is really gross. I don't know if anybody here on the line with me
I have taken fish oil before, and I've gotten that.
Yeah.
I think that's why I'm not taking it.
Yeah, and it does make people stay away from it. I can't even recommend a brand to anybody personally because I do have a more acidy system. My alkalinity needs to be fixed, so I need to work on that. I mentioned that a bit back about alkalinity. And if you have an acidy system, I think pretty much anything you take with fish oil is still going to come up on you, and you're going to taste that. So the best thing to do, I would say, is to get it in just the liquid form and then mix it into a smoothie or mix it into some type of food that's not going to break it down. So that's my recommendation. As far as brands, everything I've taken, I've had these fishy burps, which is not appealing at all. And number five, vitamin C. Huge. Another big one. You can take 500 to 2,000 daily very comfortably, and it will definitely help you. You obviously want to go in the upper range if you're coming down with something or, you are sick and you want to try to battle that. Vitamin C is so, so important. I'm going to go ahead and mention four different really strong things that it helps with. Let's see. What are we doing on time here? Okay, we're good. All right. Number one is stress. Vitamin C definitely helps with stress. Two is colds, obviously. definitely helps you to get rid of those colds and to prevent them. 3, it actually helps with strokes. It helps you to have a higher blood level of vitamin C, which actually increases the potential to other nutrients in your body. See, it's so important. If you have certain nutrients in your body, they work together hand in hand. So it's more than just taking that one individual supplement or vitamin, because if you don't have certain other things going on, then they can't work together. It's almost like a teamwork thing. And 4, skin aging. Vitamin C is so important as far as trying to stay young, and there's a lot of different things that you can buy that's natural and is organic for your skin, whether it be lotions or facial cleansing or masks or different things like that. And it really does help your skin because it helps it to be able to regenerate. It also improves your macular degeneration if you have a tendency for that, inflammation in your body, which is big, and reduces your risk of cancer and cardiovascular disease. So again, vitamin C is another very important vitamin to have in your system. 6, I listed vitamin A. That you can take 5,000 to 10,000 IUs daily, and it's very safe for you. Here are the things that it helps with. There's 7 different benefits that are listed here. 1 is immunity. 2 is eyes. 3 is bones and teeth. 4 is urinary stones. 5 is cancer. 6 is skin. And 7 is the reproductive system. So vitamin A helps quite a few things. I apologize if this was a 3-hour show. I would read all these things to you. But I'm doing my best to get as much information out there as I can within my 2 hours that I have here. So that's that for vitamin A. 7 is vitamin E. I've pretty much mainly heard 400 IU daily was good, so that's what I've listed. I didn't put a range. And it really helps with many different things, but the ones that are mentioned here, cancer and cardiovascular disease, it helps fight those things. It improves metabolism and your immune system and the ability for your immune system to fight things off. Heart diseases, fights those off as well, and also cataracts. And then my 8 choice is vitamin B12. Although all B vitamins are very important, vitamin B12 is the one particular B vitamin that a lot of people have a tendency to be deficient in, and it can do really horrible things to you. I have friends that have had this problem, and one in particular had a surgery done to, I'm trying to think of the name of it, but she got her stomach made smaller. Is anybody able to remember the name of it? I can't think of it right now.
Like a gastric bypass?
Yes, yes. Bypass. I was drawing a blank. I know the name like the back of my hand, but it wasn't coming to me. See, I need more fish oil. Anyway, my friend had such low levels of B12 because of that, having that surgery done, that she was literally dropping things, shaking. She could not function. So she all the time has to get injected with the shots. Otherwise, she cannot function properly. And that's another thing. Just one real brief stray off to a little bit of a different subject, but when you get different surgeries done to help you lose weight, I'm not shooting them down, again, not a doctor, but you do run the risk of deficiency in your vitamins, and your body cannot assimilate things properly when things have been tampered with, you know, having a, obviously they cut your stomach down to a very tiny size and all of that, and unfortunately it does end up causing problems and deficiencies. Almost everybody I know who's had it done has had some kind of problem. I'm not saying everyone, but it's more likely than not. So that's something you might want to consider. Good old-fashioned losing weight, no matter how hard it is, unless, of course, you're at a risk of really bad things that could kill you, and you know, maybe you can't take the time it takes to normally lose weight the natural way. But that is something that happens when you have that kind of a surgery done. You definitely have problems with vitamin B. A lot of people do. Here are some health benefits. Here's 5 listed. It is needed to convert carbohydrates into glucose in the body, thus leading to energy production and a decrease in fatigue and lethargy in the body. It helps in healthy regulation of the nervous system, and it reduces depression. There's another thing that reduces depression, stress and brain shrinkage. Believe it or not, your brains do shrink as you get older, especially if you don't take care of them. It helps maintain a healthy digestive system. Vitamin B12 also protects against heart disease by curbing and improving unhealthy cholesterol levels, protecting against stroke and high blood pressure. It is essential for healthy skin, hair, and nails. It helps in cell production and constant renewal of your skin. Vitamin B12 helps against cancers including breast, colon, lung, and prostate cancer. So what we're learning here is if we give our bodies what it needs, if we give our bodies everything that our body really requires, or most of it, we will naturally fight off diseases and maybe not even get them at all. So a lot of these things that you hear, oh, let's do this for, you know, let's go do this run, or let's put money together for breast cancer or whatever type of cancer or whatever disorder, it may be diabetes or whatever, the best way to combat getting any of those disorders or diseases is really to take care of your body and eat right and give yourself proper supplementation if needed. It's unbelievable the amazing machines that our bodies are, and they do have an unbelievable amount of ability to repair and to rejuvenate.
Yes, absolutely. I did want to go ahead and add, if you are listening through Facebook, we do have a website. It is www.blogtalkradio.com/talkintheshadows. Come on in. If this isn't your topic, you know, chat is very entertaining right now. You can enjoy the people that are in chat with us. We just ask that you register and like us on Facebook. Lisa?
Thank you very much for that, Robin. Yes, I have to admit, Robin is really good at remembering those little points, and a lot of times I get so much into the conversation, I forget to mention, yes, we have quite a bit of different websites that you can go to get information as far as the shows that are coming up or any updates that are going on, exciting news as far as the different things we have in the works. So definitely go to our Facebook site. And if you go there, if you go onto that fan page, you're definitely going to be able to get all the other places that we have, Google+, we have Twitter,
we have a lot of people in chat right now that are really enjoying themselves. I'm enjoying sitting here reading it. So we do encourage you to also register with the Blog Talk Radio site to be a part of that as well.
Exactly, so that you can get into chat and enjoy some of that going back and forth, which there's a lot of really cool people talking right now. I see I'm missing a lot of it. I'm so busy over here talking away. So, you're right, Robin. There's a lot of activity going there. So if you go ahead and register, not to mention that if you follow the show by going and registering and you click on follow underneath my picture, you will get notifications. Whether I don't know if it does it straight to your phones. I imagine it would if you get your emails that way. But it will email you and let you know like an hour before the show that the show is about to start, and it will give you reminders and updates. So anytime
and
I go ahead
too.
And I'm sorry, what was that?
I'm sorry, go ahead. I'm sorry to interrupt you. I thought you were
okay. I was just going to say that it also will tell you when another show has been scheduled. So it's really a nice little tool. And it also keeps us, you know, a little bit more informed, and I can get more news to people easier that way. I try my best to post it on my own personal wall. I post it on, you know, the fan page. I post it, you know, on many of the other places I mentioned. And I think the best way is to get it directly to your very own email or through your phone if you have, you know, an email that comes to your phone. So absolutely, Robin, you're absolutely right. We do need to get people to like the page and get that followed, and then to also register here at Blog Talk Radio and get all that
and if
stuff.
You have a, you know, if you have something that you want to add to the conversation, or you maybe have a different point of view, maybe you feel differently about supplements, or you have some questions regarding some supplement that you've been thinking of. I know we have some men on currently that are in chat. Men, I know a lot of times, you know, guys don't really pay attention. Sometimes they do. If there's something that you're dealing with that Lisa can maybe, you know, suggest a supplement for you or something, for something that may be going on, certainly definitely call us in.
Absolutely. Definitely want to hear from you. Speaking of calls, I have somebody that's been patiently waiting online. I believe I know who this is. I'm going to take a guess at that and let them on. Welcome to the show. Is this Dave?
Good evening, ladies. How are you this evening?
We are doing
Hello,
well.
Dave.
How are you?
Very interesting. This is a very interesting show, actually. I'm, you know, kind of on the serious side, obviously. I was looking at the description of the show, noticed it was, you know, about the New Year resolutions, get healthy. I never mentioned anything about it, but, yeah, I sort of got a resolution. I got myself a nutritionist. He doesn't cost me anything. His name is Dr. Oz. And, seriously, Friday, Dr. Oz talked about people with metabolistic issues.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Now, what have you learned from Doc? Have you learned anything from Dr. Oz?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, but some of it I'm not going to say. Apparently parts of me are 80 years old. I didn't know that. So Dr. Oz was talking Friday about metabolism, improving metabolism. He has this, the guy should be a salesman, I tell you. He says fenugreek tea herbs, L-arginine supplement, and one called cognac root, also known as glucomannan root, is the combination, according to his profiling, that might assist me in my issue.
Nice. So have you started any of that yet?
No, it's just on Friday.
Oh, okay.
Are you about ready to go and get those supplements and get started? Maybe look it up on Vitacost. I highly recommend it. I'm not doing this for them, although if they hear this, if you want to have me advertise for you, I'd be more than happy to do that. But I mainly use Vitacost, and there's a couple other websites that are very affordable on and off. I always go by what's best, but I highly recommend going online. I mean, I know you could probably go to local stores by you, but I will tell you that if you do your shopping online and you really do your research, you'll find that the supplements are going to be a lot more affordable, especially if you get free shipping, then you're not paying taxes if it's not in your area. As well, of course, they always have coupons. I love coupons. So I recommend Vitacost for you, Dave. And
Vita,
I'm sorry, what was that?
Vita what? Tell me the name of that website.
Vitacost, VITACOST.com. Vitacost. And while I have you on the line, I don't know if you want to talk about this or not, but remember something that I recommended to you and it helped you?
You're going to have to give me a little more clue than that.
Okay. Do you remember when you were told you were going to have surgery because you had gallstones?
Oh, yes. Absolutely. That worked.
And I gave you some advice on that, and it prevented you from having to have that surgery.
I canceled the surgery.
Yay!
That was awesome. No, that was seriously awesome.
I had surgery last year.
I had the surgery in 2008. So what was that?
It was apple juice.
That leads
did I spill the beans?
Go ahead, Dave.
I didn't want to spill the beans. I thought that's what I did. I just did. Never mind. It's okay. We're cool. I'll just have another. the apple juice really did work. She told me about the apple juice. She sent me this little thing on the email about the apple juice. And there was this one thing at the end that I was really, really queasy about doing. So all I did was double extended the time that I was consuming this mass quantity of apple juice. And a month later, I called and canceled the surgery. And I had never felt better in a long time. I mean, wow.
Yep. So there are natural ways. Now, it was actually a gallstone flush that I'd sent to you. And, you're supposed to drink some oil and lemon juice, and it's really kind of nasty. I personally not tried that, but Dave was like, send it to me. I want to see what I want to do here. And he ended up just drinking the apple juice. And when he drank enough apple juice, which took him quite a little bit of time to get used to it without having to run to the bathroom every 5 minutes because he was drinking quite a lot, apple juice is just so good. Apples are one of the best fruits out there for your body, and they do keep stones at bay and help break things down and get rid of them. So, yeah, for stones, absolutely. A really good organic apple juice. And apple cider is also good, too, if you can get a really good brand. Or, you know, personally, I'd say it'd be better to get it natural somewhere local where you know
it's
just.
Will that help with kidney stones?
Yes. kidney stones and gallstones. It would help with any stones in your body because there's a lot of acidity to apples. It's actually, most people don't think, they think, oh, citrus, that's got all the acid in it. Believe it or not, there's a much higher content of acid in apples. So definitely helps break down all those stones that build up in your system.
Don't apples contain something called pectin?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I thought. And that's a benefit to health also.
Yes, and you can buy that in the supplement as well, apple pectin.
I didn't know that.
I
don't need to.
I'm sorry, Dave. What was that?
I said I still love my apple juice. I don't need to buy that.
No, just if the apple juice is working for you, you know, if it's not broken, why fix it?
Exactly.
So I highly recommend it.
We do have a person in chat that says that they do have kidney stones. Is there something that you can suggest for them as far as diet or supplements? Because I know that, didn't you have an issue with that at one time?
Me personally, I still do. But
okay.
I've been trying to keep them at bay with supplementation. And I also have something, I'll probably have to go dig it out because I'm guilty of not using it all the time. It was recommended to me by a very wonderful friend of mine that is a Queensryche fan. And
Queens who?
I'm sorry, what was that, Dave?
Queens who?
Queensryche, ha ha. And it's by a brand.
Now, remember, you know, any information we share is based on our own experiences, knowledge, or research or guidance that Lisa has received either from doing her research or from professionals in the health field. So make sure that you know that, you know.
Before you start a supplement or before you know you actually have a need for the supplement, please see a doctor, whether it be Western medicine typical doctor or a naturopath or homeopathic doctor.
Yeah.
Absolutely. But the supplement, which anybody out there who has stones, I highly recommend this as well. I'm guilty of not taking it all the time because they're huge, but it's by a brand called Planetary Herbals, and it's called Stone Free. So if you want to look that up, that's definitely a good one for you if you have stones. That helps kidney and gallstones. And I personally know how painful they are, and it's awful, 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 awful. I mean, I would have 20 babies as opposed to passing these stones. Seriously, it's that bad. So that's something I recommend. Again, not a professional, but it's something you might want to look into. But while we're sitting here talking, I see we've got someone else that's cropped up on us.
And we're not talking about the song from Jimi Hendrix, Stone Free.
Oh, and by the way, Hug has asked me in chat if it's Christy. Yes, it's Christy. She was so wonderful to help me through some of that, and she gave me a lot of really wonderful advice. And that was the one thing that she definitely said worked for her. So she avoided having to have surgery because of that, and that is so wonderful because if you can avoid surgery, that's amazing. So let's go ahead and get our other caller who's been waiting for a little bit to the show. Here we go. Welcome to the show. Who am I speaking to?
This is Rhonda.
Hello.
Well, hi.
Hello.
Rhonda.
Hi,
that's
Robin.
My sister, Rhonda. How are you, Rhonda?
I'm well, thank you. Actually, I was just going to say that the apple cider vinegar you want really is Bragg's Organic Apple Cider Vinegar, and that is one of the best, and it's a raw apple cider vinegar that's good for what you're talking about. As well as my sister's pastor actually used, I think it was 2 ounces of olive oil and 2 ounces of lemon juice and got rid of kidney stones. So that works.
Yeah, that's the flush I'm talking about. And as far as apple cider vinegar, we're just talking about straight apple, just regular apple juice. But yes, apple cider vinegar, though I personally can't stand the taste of it, I'll be honest, that actually is wonderful for stones.
Yeah.
And you mentioned
it, too.
We've
done it like on a regular basis, like in the evenings in the winter a lot of times, and if you do like 2 tablespoons in hot water in a cup with a little bit of a really good thing that we've used all winter. You would have just a slight cough or a tickle. Use Manuka. It's raw. And on it, the tea trees in New Zealand and Australia, then that will kick anything out. But if you do the apple cider vinegar in the hot water and drink it that way with the honey, it actually is pretty tolerable and very effective. It'll keep you well all.
Yeah, that's another really important thing. Yeah, you're right. I was going to talk a little bit more on that when we talk about food next week. But, yeah, as far as stones, since we're on the topic of stones, I absolutely agree with you on that. And the flush you mentioned is basically the one I was talking about with the alum.
I'm sorry, I missed that. What was that, a tablespoon of what? What was it? Olive oil and what else?
Lemon juice.
Oh, okay.
Well, the flush that I learned about, you had to drink like a whole cup of olive oil and you had to do it in increments, like tolerate it. But there's, I mean, I'm sure there's different versions of the same flush out there. So you kind of have to do your research and decide which one you think you can do. But while we're still going along here, I'm just going to go ahead and mention the last two on my list. And then we're just going to have open chat for the last 20 minutes that we've got going here, about maybe about 15, really.
Yeah, so stick around, Rhonda. Are you still there?
Actually, I think that her call was dropped because she was having phone problems. That's why you couldn't understand her. It sounded garbled a little bit. She's back on, so let me go ahead and grab her real quick before I go ahead and mention the last two supplements on my list. Hi, is that Rhonda there?
Yes, it is. Sorry. I dropped you somehow.
Having phone problems.
Well, we'll go ahead and keep you on the line. She has a couple more things to share, Rhonda, and if you have any more comments, we'd like to hear them, okay?
Okay.
Great. Thanks for calling back.
Yeah, you bet. Thanks.
Okay, number 9 on my list is glucosamine chondroitin with MSM. As far as doses, they vary depending on the brand and which mixture that you're getting as far as with MSM, without, things like that. But glucosamine chondroitin is so good for supporting your joints and connective tissues. It's often used to ease the pain of osteoarthritis, particularly for the knee, according to the Mayo Clinic. It's a combination of three compounds, glucosamine chondroitin and methyl sulfonyl methane, which is MSM, easier to pronounce, better to say MSM. But glucosamine, It exists naturally in healthy cartilage. It is an important component in the body's ability to make peptidoglycans and glycosaminoglycans. Or they call them GAGs, which are compounds of cartilage. Normally, as the body moves, cartilage is worn away and reshaped. As a result, it resumes its normal shape and restores itself. If glucosamine levels are low, the repair process is slowed down. According to the pain clinic, taking glucosamine supplements can increase the body's production of those two things I mentioned that are hard to pronounce and improve the natural repair process. Chondroitin is actually chondroitin sulfate and is one of the GAGs. Molecules of chondroitin sulfate blend with proteins to make prostaglandins. And prostaglandins are essential in all connective tissues in your body, such as cartilage, ligaments, and tendons. Chondroitin supplements appear to increase the hyaluronic acid, which is another great supplement, an important part of the synovial fluid, which lubricates your joints. Synovial fluid is actually what makes that noise when you snap your knuckles or your knees pop or whatever. It's actually not the bone popping. It's actually the fluids flowing through the chambers of, you know, your joints. So that's kind of a weird thing to know. I never used to know that. I used to think my bones were actually cracking when I was snapping my knuckles. Like, not cracking, breaking, but rubbing against each other or something. I didn't know. You know, you're a kid. You don't know those things. But that's actually the fluid, the synovial fluid. And it decreases pain and swelling because the chondroitin actually helps that synovial fluid to work. MSM is a natural sulfur compound. Sulfur is a fundamental mineral used by the body to maintain the immune system, balance hormones, control the activity of enzymes, and promote healthy joint function. Some research implies that MSM can improve the flexibility of joints while minimizing pain and swelling. It is thought to be able to reduce and soften scar tissue and break down calcium deposits while improving circulation. Now, important thing to think about is that the calcium deposits you get in your joints actually is what arthritis is. if you can take things that will help break those calciums down, including some of the other things I mentioned before that help break stones down and such, which stones are a lot of times calcium, if you can break those down, you can get rid of your arthritis. And another key to that is keeping moving, because when the calcium deposits get rubbed on, they break down and they eventually go away. So you don't have to be riddled with arthritis the rest of your life if you do certain things and take certain steps to get rid of it or to keep it at bay. So that's something I wanted to make sure to mention too. So basically, I definitely recommend taking that personally. Definitely helps for pain and definitely helps repair to some extent. I mean, it's not going to repair it to good as new, but it will definitely help. And the last thing I put on my list is milk thistle. You can take roughly 300 to 600 milligrams daily. Milk thistle is a very important herbal supplement because it detoxifies and protects vital liver functions and more. What's really important about making sure your liver is cleansed and healthy is because it is basically your filter to your, you know, through your whole body. It filters all the toxins out and it keeps you healthy. If your liver is riddled with toxins and all sorts of nasty gunk from all the foods you've eaten that are bad for you, and you know, if you don't keep that clean, or you don't eat things that help cleanse it, or take supplements like milk thistle. Milk thistle is basically a little plant, a little flower. You know, you're going to end up getting sicker, and a lot of things start in the liver. You have a lot of liver issues, and your liver can start to die. What's really great about the liver, though, it has an unbelievable ability to regrow and repair itself. Believe it or not, if you have a bad part of your liver and they remove it, it will actually regrow. Which is crazy, I know, but it does do that. It does. It's kind of like a starfish. If you cut off one of its stars, it'll regrow a new one.
Mm-hmm. Well, so. I think, you know, our bodies have the amazing ability to heal itself. I mean, when you cut it, when we get cut, we get or a scratch or a wound, it'll close up and heal itself. And if we give the inside of our bodies the ability to feed it the right things and the things that will help it and to nurture it, then it's going to heal itself too. There's no reason it shouldn't act just like the outside.
And actually, what the largest organ in your body is your skin. People don't realize
right.
Skin is actually an organ. So
right.
You're absolutely right. If you can cut your hand wide open and have it grow back and sometimes have zero scarring, why can't
right.
your insides grow?
Right.
So people really underestimate our body's abilities to repair and heal themselves. And
right. And it's just,
you know,
ignorant, you know, that's all.
It really is.
Lack of understanding.
Mm-hmm. It mainly is ignorance. And it doesn't mean you're stupid. It just means you're lacking the knowledge and you don't know these
right.
things.
That's right. Lacking information. That's right.
So I'm just trying to put out anything I can. And, you know, we've got about 15 minutes to go here, so anything else that anyone wants to share here on our little group here that I've got on the phone line, or if anybody else that is sitting there has maybe got a question and they really want to answer, maybe call it in, and maybe we'll see what we can do as far as helping you out with an answer. Or if you're in chat, if you want to type a question down, we'll go ahead and do our best to answer that as well. But I hope that I'm saying things in a way that I'm not stumbling too much over some of the pronunciations. Some of the words are very hard to say. Actually, I've heard doctors butcher them too, so I guess I'm not the only one. But I'm just trying to do my best as far as to share the knowledge that I have and try to share some of the things I've collected that I think are very useful. So does anybody here have anything to say?
This is Rhonda, and I came in late, so I didn't hear if you talked anything about juicing for detoxing.
No. Like I said, next week is about foods, so I was going to go into things like juicing and that. But, yes, juicing is very good for detoxing. And you could actually live on juicing very well. The only thing is, obviously, people want to have roughage in their body so that they can, you know, eliminate things out of their body. But if you're only juicing, well, obviously that's going to come out. The only problem with juicing, too, is if you do too much, you're going to be in the bathroom a lot. But from what I've read, if you get your body used to it, that problem goes away. Kind of like Dave, where he was getting used to drinking more and more apple juice, and eventually he wasn't in the bathroom 24 hours a day. Am I right,
right.
Dave?
Yeah,
well,
you do.
Knowing...
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, Rhonda.
It's knowing the right combinations of juices, too, and understanding what you pair together and what you don't. There's certain vegetables and fruits that you should not combine together, and that's, you know, that can make a difference as well.
Well, we might want to have you call back next week and share some of that if you have any.
Yeah, that would be
It would be nice to hear that, because I know that you've done that for years. My sister is a huge advocate in taking care of her body, and her skin is immaculate. So, I know that you would have some really good things to share.
Yeah, absolutely. I'd love to hear
about
it.
One of the things with the apple that people don't realize in the detoxing process is the thing that is so instrumental in that is the pectin that's in the apples, and that's what neutralizes the toxins as you're flushing your body of the toxins, is the pectin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Dave, remember we were talking about the pectin.
Okay.
So that goes hand in hand with what she's saying.
Right.
It does more than you think, you know. It's amazing.
It's good stuff, Maynard.
Now, is there anybody else that's a guest that's currently on the line that does take a supplement daily? Or maybe one of the ones that Lisa had mentioned?
Does anybody have any questions, or would you like me to go back and touch on a few other things?
I just take one a day silver.
Oh, that reminds me. You just got me to think of something I did want to mention. Thanks, Dave. And one a day silver, actually, yeah, my mom used to take that. Until, here we go, God, they should pay me for this. Until I started taking a whole food energizer by Nature's Way, again, I definitely like Nature's Way. They have a multivitamin by the name of Alive. And Alive is wonderful. There is so much good stuff in here. I've got their website open, and I'll just like kind of run down it a little bit, but I can't possibly name everything. I'll be here for an hour. But,
what's the website so I can put it in chat there for you?
Naturesway.com, and then just look in Alive, look up Alive Whole Food Energizer, and it should find it. But it's naturesway.com. And they everything I've ever used from them has been wonderful. And Alive is definitely at the top. If you say you don't want to go through getting all these separate supplements, and you find that you may think, oh, it's too costly, and I don't want to take that, you know, whole handful of pills every day, Alive is really good. Of course, there's going to be some things in their little grouping of the multivitamin where you're going to need a little more than what they're offering you within that particular, you know, grouping, which you may have to get. Say, okay, for me, for example, what they give me doesn't give me enough magnesium. I need more than what's in there. The average person is wonderful on what they give. But for me, I need more. So that's where you might want to get a supplement in addition. But if you want an overall wonderful whole food energizer that's going to give you energy, that's going to have fruits and vegetables, I mean, this is made from whole foods, the best of the best. And I'm going to go ahead and just mention a little bit of what's in there. The one I get has no iron. I cannot tolerate iron. It makes me very sick to my stomach. And iron is something I'm not going to go into it right now because there's not a lot of time, but if you have too much iron, it can cause problems. You can get poisoning from it. Iron's wonderful and important, but unfortunately not an easy thing to take and know when you're taking too much and all of that. So because I have a lack of tolerance for it, and I try to get it elsewhere in my foods and that, I don't get the iron added version, but the ultimate nutritional energy source contains the greatest diversity of daily essentials, whole food concentrates, phytonutrients, and antioxidants to nourish, protect, and invigorate your body. These multivitamins are made with daily essentials, botanical energizers, and system defenders, including 25 vitamins and minerals, 10 amino acids, 12 digestive enzymes, 14 green foods, 12 organically grown mushrooms, and 40-plus antioxidants. As with all Alive multivitamins, they're also packed with high-potency B vitamins, 20-plus fruits and vegetables, and nutrients for whole-body nourishment to help support bone health, daily energy, colon health, eye health, heart health, and immune defense. So I wanted to mention at the end, I'm so glad Dave mentioned his Centrum Silver that he likes to use. But I personally definitely recommend as just your friend alive. I'm not a doctor, but it has done wonders for me and for the people in my family that have been using it. And I will tell you, within 20 minutes of taking it, you feel energy. It's like, whoa. Like, I remember when I first started to take it, I took it, like, I forget what time. It was late because I'm a night owl. And I couldn't go to sleep. I was up for a whole day after that because it gave me so much energy. So this is something I definitely recommend, my personal, just my opinion.
Now, is this a pill or is it a liquid?
Well, they come in tablet form or they come in V-caps. And you can get it in the liquid form. It's just more expensive that way. I like to get it in the V-caps because they break down faster and they assimilate faster. But the tablets are probably the most economical to get. And you don't have to take as many. You do have to take more of the V-caps. So you take
also
up to six
too,
per
you
day.
Know, I was reading that it doesn't include any dairy products, sugar, wheat, yeast, artificial covering, coloring, or flavoring. So that's nice.
Gluten-free. What was that? How did you say the name of that?
Nature'sWay.com.
Yeah.
That's the brand.
It's
right.
On the chat there, if you have it.
Oh,
are you in chat, babe? Yeah.
Sorry, I was actually placing an order on that website that Lisa recommended.
Looks like Robin's gone ahead and put the woman's multi, but there's the men's version and there's
no,
just an oatmeal version.
I put the men's first and then the women's.
Oh, I see. Okay, I had to scroll back. Very cool. I see you've got another caller. I'm pretty sure I know who this is, but let's go ahead and add them in our last 5 minutes of the show. Welcome to the show. Is this by chance Doug?
Yo, yo, yo. Are you psycho?
Dougie.
How do you always know it's me?
Because I see the phone number.
Or wait, you probably have caller ID, duh.
Duh. That's how I screen people. So if you're coming here to troll, you are not.
You were on a roll. Good show.
Thanks, Doug.
I didn't want to call in. I just wanted to listen. A lot of good information. I'm going to check that Alive out. I definitely need something. And you know what I hate is like trying to take 18 different vitamins. I can't do it. I try.
Absolutely. I'm not a pill person either. Don't like it.
The biggest pain in the ass.
It can be pretty overbearing, and, you know, you've got a whole handful, and you're like, I got to swallow all of this, you know, especially some of the really monster horse ones.
I can't.
Well, not
do
only
that,
but you don't want to take it all at one time, you know what I mean? And then you
forget some of them you can.
The garbage.
Some of it you want to separate. And some of the supplements, it's best to break it up, take half of it during the morning hours or afternoon, and then the rest before bed. And some stuff you don't want to take close to bedtime because it'll make you all wired and all full of energy.
It'll make you stay up all night and have sex or something crazy like that.
Oh, darn. That's horrible.
Oh, darn.
Sorry. That's okay.
I remember those days.
Yeah.
That's
the
next show. Okay. Robin,
so next week you're talking
about.
Yeah, when's the next show?
And we can get that where?
You can get that on naturesway.com, and they have a lot of other wonderful supplements. I'm looking right now at their magnesium complex. My mom also uses their B vitamin complex, which is wonderful. They have a lot of really, really great supplements on there. And like I said, I wish that they would have, you know, want me to advertise for them because I definitely would do it anyway. But wonderful, wonderful.
Well, Nature's Way is typically found in a number of health food stores, so you should be able to get it there as well as online.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, I recommend VitaCost, though. I mean, I know you can go to their website.
Oh, me too. I like ordering from VitaCost. You can't beat them hands down for price-wise. So.
No, you cannot. And they always have specials, and sometimes they'll have 25% off their own brand. And I've found that their brand, their VitaCost brand, is actually really good as well.
Mm-hmm.
But you can't always find exactly what you want in their brand. So sometimes you have to do things like Nature's Way and some of the other ones out there. But in answer to Doug's question, he wants to know the next show. We're having a series of four shows about living well in 2012, and the next show will be same time, same bat channel, which is next Sunday from 10 p.m. until 12 a.m., and the next show will be about fantastic foods. And that's going to be about, like Rhonda was saying, about juicing, about what foods are superfoods and are really good for you that you should take for, into your system for different reasons, whether it's antioxidants or the different nutrition that's within it. But we're going to talk about superfoods, and I named it Fantastic Foods. But the third show, I'll just go ahead and mention all four of them. The third show will be about water and how important water is to get enough water in your system, and drinking safe water, too, because the regular tap water is absolutely awful. And you definitely need to get the best filter system out there you can within your range of money, but not everybody can afford to get a reverse osmosis, and that's something I'll go into a little bit more. But that is called Water for Well-Being. And same time every Sunday from 10 p.m., and that's Eastern Standard Time, till 12 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And when I go ahead and put the event out there, I always mention the different time zones so you can look at it and see accordingly to where you're from. And then the fourth show is about exercise for your body and mind. And I wanted to make sure and touch on things about things that are good for your mind as well. So many people just focus on getting their body in good shape, but they don't work on their mind. You know, meditation, positive thinking, keeping the negative out of their life.
Actually, that seems to be my forte.
Yeah, see, Robin's
been
playing a lot there.
There's an interesting website, too, for just mind games that you can play, not mind games, but I mean games that you can play to help your memory and to keep sharp in your mind. So, yeah, it would be an interesting show.
So those are the four shows that we had scheduled. Today was obviously the first one, and then there's the other three. We also have our Wednesday shows that are free for all, where we talk about really anything. We just never know where it's going to go. The first week was successful. We really needed the 2 hours. I only had it be 1 hour, so the following shows will from now on be 2 hours. I don't know that I'm going to do them every month, but I'm definitely going to try to make at least one per month from this point on. After this month, we'll have one every Wednesday. And it's the same time, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard till 12 a.m. Eastern Standard. So you want to keep those on your calendar if you can come and join us and have some fun and just get wild and, you know, talk about all sorts of diverse topics. I never know what it's going to be about. So I can't really...
We
never know
ground,
what comes out on Wednesday. But we survive, don't we? Yeah, we do.
We get through it, whatever it may be. So that's what we have going on for that. We've got a bunch of really cool stuff going on for February. I'm going to try to get this in here before I have to play my outro. But the show's for February, with February being Valentine's month, February 5th, which, again, Sundays, my typical time, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time till 12 a.m. Eastern Standard. We're going to have a show that's called Romantic Ideas and Tips, and basically I'm going to have people call in. I'm going to have a bunch of ideas, Robin as well, I'm sure we'll work together, and we're going to help people out there that really don't know what the heck to do for their boyfriend, girlfriend,
This is your year to know what to do for your sweetheart on Valentine's Day, so
right.
Be sure
we're
to tune in for that show.
Time to be able to do it, so we're going to do that on the 5th, and that's a Sunday. They're all Sundays except for the Wednesday, all free-for-alls. The 12th will be Valentine's Day Madness, and that's within 2 days of Valentine's Day, so people are going to be going crazy trying to do things last minute. But we're going to be talking about the subject of Valentine's Day, how it got its start, people's feelings on it, what they think about it, as far as, you know, is it important? Is it really just a holiday to sell a bunch of cards and flowers, chocolates and such? We're getting low here on time, so I'm going to quickly mention the other two, and then we're going to have to say our goodbyes. But February 19th is going to be all about women, and it's going to be titled Women Are from Venus. We are going to have a wonderful show with that. I can go into that more next week and explain it a bit more when we have more time. The final show in February is February 26th, and that will be about men and what makes them tick, and it will be called Men Are from Mars. So we have some really cool stuff coming up the following month after this month, so I hope you'll stick with us. Call in. Listen in and tell your friends and family, spread the word. You know, we're doing the best we can to get it out there, and we just really want to have a lot of fun and inform people in the different informative shows. So thank you so much, everyone who's called, everyone who's had any input. I really appreciate it. It's been a wonderful show. As always, it always ends up working out so well, and I'm so happy for that. We do have an outro, but before I go ahead and play that, again, I just want to say goodbye to everyone. If everyone wants to just quickly say goodbye here, then we're going to go ahead and do the outro.
See you later.
All right.
Talk
goodbye,
to you later.
People.
Yeah.
I'll talk
bye.
To you Wednesday.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you very much,
have
all of our guests.
Great evening. Take care of yourselves, and most importantly, try to stay as healthy as you can, because this year is going to be a doozy. So everyone, take love to you all.
Have a good night, everyone.
Good night.